Some of you stood up, thank you. Like, are you married? He said, oh, yeah, yeah. And I said, what did your wife say about this? He said, oh, she encouraged me to do it.
Travel to Mars one way.
Okay! He has a timetable of like the 2020s. I don't think he'll make his timetable. He has his heart is in the right place. He has to fund it in a way that makes sense. And you can't just do it wishing the money would arise. So, plus the Dutch, historically, were great explorers. We don't think about it that way because they didn't conquer and put their flags everywhere the way the Spanish did and the British and the French. But the Dutch were everywhere. Like, practically 10 minutes behind Christopher Columbus was the Dutch East India Trading Company. Waiting to see if he's gonna die so they don't do what he does, so they won't die, okay? They take his notes and then they trade with the world. So it's an interesting cultural legacy that the Dutch have for that. Will NASA be the first on Mars? If anyone is the first on Mars, I think it will have to be NASA, not Elon Musk, even though the press keeps describing it that way. It's not that I don't want him to be the first on Mars, there's just no business case to do so, and he's running a business. What does that venture capitalist meeting look like? He's sitting there, and these are money bags coming in. Okay, so Elon, how much will this mission cost? Hundreds of billions of dollars, okay? Are there any risks? Yeah. Will people die? Probably. What's the return on this investment? None that I can think of so far. That is a 5-minute meeting. What happens is governments take those risks. Governments don't have to meet the quarterly report or the annual report because governments are here forever in their own mind. They're here forever. So they can make an investment that returns in 10 years, 20 years. When Christopher Columbus went to the New World by the Spanish government, Queen Isabella didn't say, oh, Chris, when you come back, give us a slideshow on the beautiful peoples. And no, it's, here's a satchel of flags. Plant them everywhere you go in the name of Spain. There were hegemonistic motives. Love that word, hegemony. This is motivations for your own self-interest in the domination of others. Hegemony. So what can happen is we decide that NASA should go, and Elon Musk has a spaceship ready to sell them. So Elon Musk can stay in business by selling spaceships to NASA that'll get us to Mars, back to the moon and Mars. And that's a business model. Lockheed Martin, Boeing have been doing that in the aerospace industry ever since they've been born. So that's my read of the future in space that we face. And I wrote a whole book on this, which is why I don't feel like talking about it anymore. Yeah, right here, yes. Now, coming from your anus to check myself.